It's been months now since I was shipwrecked on a desert island where I took refuge, the only survivor of the wreck. I've been able to live since then by struggling for my life each day, in a solitude that's not without its advantages. There is no war, no epidemics, and no talkative women. The climate is hot and dry, and I live in a comfortable cave, except for a rather low ceiling. But with a little work, that can be arranged. I must still be under the effects of the shock. I see a hole in the wall of the cave, and I'm sure that there isn't one there. Yes, there is. Dick can get out. There's no mistake. The cave-in created a second opening. You've got to be buried alive before you can really appreciate fresh air and sunshine. The sun in this country is a bit strong for my English scalp, but what work it is to make a parasol. Yes, what work in all the trades I've practiced the year I've been on this island. Carpenter, cabinet maker, trapper of goats, miner in order to open my cave. I can be proud of my success in hunting, fishing, cooking, sewing, and even in parasol making. Dick seems to particularly appreciate my parasol. He adopted it as his own right away. I'd better put a stop to that. He doesn't have an English scalp. Since I need kitchenware, I take up a new trade, pottery making. Now it's going well. result isn't beautiful, but it seems strong. I must have made a mistake somewhere. You have to milk goats every day. I don't know what to do anymore with all the milk. I'm going to try to make some cheese. It shouldn't be too difficult. It's one of the few good things to eat that the English make. I can still remember the cheese in York. For equipment, I have a wooden tub from the wreck of the Esmeralda and some gourds furnished by the island. Seem bad at all. I'm enjoying myself in advance. I was right to enjoy myself first. After, there may be disappointment. Perhaps a bit more salt. Now there's too much salt. I'll have to take care not to have such a heavy hand. But maybe I'm being too difficult. Dick wouldn't be so fussy. Even he doesn't want my cheese. And he eats everything. A true gourmet puts me to shame. I don't dare believe this miracle. I want to convince myself that it's only a weed. But no, it's really corn. Exactly in the spot I threw the seeds the parrot didn't want. No doubt about it, the seeds have sprouted. A few weeks, and here it is, fully grown. In this virgin earth, everything goes miraculously. I'll be able to sow, to cultivate, to reap. I need some baskets to gather this God-given grain and plant it again. Now I'm a basket weaver. I can see that on this island I'll become a jack of all trades. Sword, symbol of war, death, and bloodshed, is going to become a peaceful farming implement in the hands of the harvester. I make a strange discovery. Any man placed in the midst of ripe grain soon becomes a poet, and this since the beginning of time. Since I haven't a mill, I'm going to grind my grain between two stones, as our ancestors did for thousands of years. Beautiful. I make a superb dough out of it. The bread should be excellent, but the results of my culinary efforts up till now haven't been reassuring. They look good. And they smell wonderful. That's something. But let's be honest. Cornbread, particularly made without yeast, isn't a light dish. Just the same, I can't recall ever having eaten anything better. No one, since the beginning of the world, no one has ever been so unskilled at fishing as I. Yet, after a lot of practice, I managed to catch quite a few, which proves that nothing is impossible for man. Last, I'm going to do something which I know already. When I was a slave in Africa, I cleaned and salted fish. I'm second to none in that art. Even the time I spent in slavery is useful now. Thanks to my knowledge, I'm going to be able to build up a store of food. Every day, I perform 20 distinct tasks, but I must religiously respect the day of rest, Sunday. If not, I'll collapse from fatigue. The day of the Lord, I have the right to a pipe. I still have some tobacco from the wreck.
Son, Robin, son. Poor, poor Robin, son.
One of nature's laws, I was told in school, is that every man who lives in a cave sooner or later scribbles on the walls. It's an idiosyncrasy which seems to have lasted 50,000 years. I see no reason to be an exception. It really is a cannon. There's a ship off the island. Hurry, hurry, the fire. At night, its light will be seen from the horizon. It's there. In spite of the fog, they can't help seeing my fire. I'm going to keep it going all night. Undoubtedly, they won't dare land before daylight. Once the sun comes up, they'll come to see what's going on. If not, I'll swim out to them. I've been waiting for this moment for a year and a half. I don't see it anymore. There's too much fog. They're ringing the bell because of the fog. A terrifying idea. The cannon, then the bell. It comes back to me. All sailors know what that means. The cannon and the bell. It's the plague. The plague on board. The most terrible of all dilemmas. Must I die of solitude here on this island? Or of a horrible disease on the ship? Why leave my island, where, after all, I've survived? But on the other hand, how can I allow this ship that I've been waiting for so long, to go away without me? I'll approach the ship cautiously. If there's the plague, I'll return. If not, farewell to my island. All I can do for them is to give them back their freedom, so they'll be able to find their own food. My goats, my birds, will gradually return to their wild state. Understood. The ship went aground in the same place as the Esmeralda. I used my raft again. No sign of life. Nothing stirring. It looks as if there's been an epidemic of the plague on board. Well, I've come this far. If it's the plague, too bad. No, it's not the plague. People who die of the plague turn black. It's a drinking bout. I should have suspected it. This man is dead drunk. It's good to see a human face after so long. A pirate flag. They drank. They killed one another. If I'm afraid of an empty bottle now. I'll explore the ship. It's not very inviting, but maybe I'll find some wounded men. It's not what I was hoping for. Having a pirate as a companion on my island hardly attracts me. The rolling of the ship that makes the bell ring. They must have set upon one another when they were dividing the loot. What riches! The fruit of years of piracy. All for nothing. Now you're all dead. All? Maybe there are some survivors waiting to attack me. Really all dead. The others must have fallen overboard. Let's not separate them. Even if I can get it afloat again, how can I sail this huge vessel all alone? And how can I hope to reach a port? The wisest thing is to take everything useful ashore, even things that aren't useful, like this beautiful coat embroidered with gold. While I'm at it, I'll take along the bell in memory of good Captain Darrick. For stripping a ship down to the last nail, I already have the necessary experience and the equipment. Strange. After this disappointment, my loneliness weighs heavier than ever. And yet, I'm happy to be back on my island. Want to take advantage of their freedom. Dick is waiting for me. Undoubtedly, he would have waited for me until he died. And now, life goes on.